Hello friends, welcome back to another episode by Engineering Today, and hope you're all having a great time. After waiting for a long time, the news finally came. The big upgraded Booster 9 was taken to the launch complex from Megabay for the last time before its next important event. It displayed its hot staging ring. The booster's engines were all covered up. We can't tell if any of them were changed. When the sun went down, the launch place was almost empty. The only vehicles coming were there to help slow vehicles get back on the road. Some machines were still working, but not for much longer. They were probably getting ready for the storm that was coming. In the middle of the bad weather, Booster 9 was moved out. Before this happened, a local officer came to visit. SpaceX was being very careful about the move. There's no use in having people stuck if the road gets flooded, which can happen even with normal heavy rain. Let's hope everyone stays safe out there. Speaking of Booster 9, a few days ago, a hot staging ring showed up, and it was quite different from the ones we've seen before. This one was stronger and had a protective dome in the middle. Later, it was moved to the Mega Bay. In the past, the way the Starship separated was very simple. It used three clamps to connect the booster and the ship. When the rocket reached the point where it needed to separate, these clamps would let go. The rocket would tilt a bit, and the ship would come off the booster because of natural forces. Even though this method was simple, it had some problems. The Starship uses a system to pressurize itself using its own gases. These gases go back into the fuel tanks, making pressure that helps the fuel flow correctly. This system also prevents the engines from making a vacuum in the tanks, which could be really bad. Stopping the engines would mess up the fuel left in the tanks. Without the thrust from the engines, the fuel would slosh around, making it really hard to restart the engines later. Also, stopping the Super Heavy's Raptor engines for a short time would be really bad. In space travel, every second counts. Stopping the engines even for a second lets gravity win. And that wastes the energy that was used to launch the rocket. That energy should be used to carry more stuff into space. In simple words, the normal way of separating the ship and booster isn't very efficient. To solve these problems, SpaceX came up with hot staging. Hot staging means turning off only some of the engines, leaving the central three Raptor engines on but at a lower power. The ship is still held by clamps, but instead of relying on the right forces, the ship's engines are ignited while it's still attached to the booster. This makes the ship and booster separate more forcefully. To make this work, the exhaust gases need a way to get out, or else the rocket could explode when the clamps let go before the engines start. That's why SpaceX made this unique ring design to protect against this. Once this special part was taken to the Mega Bay, it became clear that this ring is like a big stinger, so there's no need to worry about it being strong enough. By looking at the data, it seems that when everything is put together, the ship's engines are really close to the upper dome with just a few centimeters of space. This leads us to some interesting ideas. Elon Musk confirmed that the booster engines will be turned off, and only three Raptor engines will stay on, but at a lower power. After that, we think that the three vacuum Raptors on the ship will start with less power to make sure the dome isn't damaged. Once the ship is far enough from the booster, the other three engines will go to full power. Now, let's go back to the Starbase facility. On the 22nd of August, at the LC, SpaceX put in a new machine that heats up CH4. They named this machine Hippos. It's like a kettle that boils water, but for CH4. This machine will make the process of putting CH4 into the Starship rocket faster. On the 20th of August, they started demolishing the midbay. It was its last day. On this day, they began tearing it down using an excavator. This wasn't a big surprise because the building wasn't super useful for SpaceX. It's not big enough to put together the ships, so it doesn't make sense to keep it. This makes us wonder, is SpaceX thinking about making another huge area just for building ships? Would it take the place of the midbay? Well, they started taking the midbay down, starting from the front side, and then they began to tear down the backside as well. The demolition work is being done so they can build HB3. After that's done, they can also break down HB and build MB4. And now let's shift our focus to the moon. The first group of astronauts to go to NASA's Moon Orbiting Gateway space station will be the Artemis 4 crew in 2028, if everything happens as planned. The Americans have been open about wanting to live on the moon. They also dream of making it a base to explore more of space. The U.S. Space Agency is taking small steps, or maybe really big steps, to make this happen. They're sending astronauts to visit the moon's surface and build a space station around it. This station could be called the Gateway. It's a big project. It'll be the first space station for humans outside Earth. If everything goes well, the first crew to live in the space station will be the Artemis 4 crew in 2028, according to Stephanie Dudley, who's in charge of making sure everything works well for Gateway. They did a test flight around the moon in 2022, and they'll send astronauts around the moon in a crewed mission late in 2024. They're making plans and starting to build Gateway. NASA gave a contract worth $1 billion to Northrop Grumman to build the Habitation and Logistics Outpost, or HALO, module. This module will be where 4 astronauts live. They'll build it on Earth and launch it into space using a SpaceX Falcon Heavy rocket in November 2025. There are other parts they need to build, like the Human Landing System, HLS. This is a capsule that'll take astronauts to the moon's surface and connect them with Gateway in the future. NASA got criticism for picking only SpaceX to make the HLS, and Blue Origin sued NASA because of this. It made SpaceX stop working on the capsule for a while. Later, NASA chose Blue Origin to make a second lunar lander. Dudley said that the Artemis 5 crew will add a module for refueling and another living module to Gateway. This mission will launch in September 2029. Gateway won't need astronauts all the time, like the ISS. It can work on its own for up to 3 years. It'll use its sensors to study the moon and send information back to Earth constantly. Other space agencies and companies want to go to the South Pole of the moon because it's really important. Scientists want to know about ice from a long time ago. This ice can teach us about moon volcanoes, stuff that came to Earth from space, and where Earth's oceans came from. If there's enough ice, it can be turned into water for drinking and to cool machines. It can also be changed into fuel for rockets and air to breathe, which would help us go to Mars or mine things on the moon. India's space agency plans to try to land on the moon's south pole soon. Another Indian try in 2019 didn't work well, but they're trying again. The United States and China also want to go to the same part of the moon. This shows that many countries are interested in exploring and learning from this special place on the moon. And that's all for now. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.